Our pilot project is a residential building having three floors, commonly known as a G plus 2 building, meaning ground plus two stories. The building plinth area is 600 square feet, that is 20 feet wide by 30 feet in length. In meters, it will be 6.09 meter by 9.14 meter with a 15 feet road on the front side, and on the other three sides there are adjacent plots. Client requirements are as follows. Number 1, a shop, living hall, bedroom, kitchen, washroom and stairs on the ground floor, and on the first and second floors, two room blocks with toilets attached. So on each upper floors, two families can live as a tenant. Architectural design features. So I have planned the entire building floor wise, and what I have considered is all the rooms are as per the client requirements. Stair is planned in the front portion because it gives elegant look and easy access to tenants without causing any disturbance to others. Duct is provided for light and ventilation purposes near washrooms and kitchen. First thing is to decide the column numbers and the location. Based on the span and constraints, the sizes of columns and footings can be increased. Let's say for 150 square feet, we require 4 columns for stability plus 2 additional columns for every 150 square feet increase. So here in our case, it is 600 square feet plot area, so we require 4 plus 2 multiplied by 3 is equal to 10 numbers of columns. Some criteria for a stable design are, number 1, you can add more columns for stability wherever there are cantilever beams. At every intersection of walls, you can simplify the analysis by the provision of columns. And number 3, for locations where there are chances of frequent human movement, it is advised to add more columns to reduce the vibrations in the slab. Whenever vibrations are noticed by the occupant, he may feel unsafe and insecure. So you need to put additional columns in at such locations. Once column location and numbers are finalized, you need to select the column sizes. A table representing the current sizes are displayed here for ready reference. So the wall thickness can be 9 inches or 6 inches. So based on that, the least dimension of column can be decided. So you can see in the table, the column sizes are 9 inch by 12 inch, 9 inch by 15 inch, 9 inch by 18 inch, and 9 inch by 21 inch are some common sizes. Wall thickness governs the shorter column size. Some owners recommend to use 6 inch wall thickness. Based on this, you can have the option to select 6 inch by 12 inch or 6 inch by 15 inch, 6 inch by 18 inch, and 6 inch by 21 inch size of the columns. Now let us decide which size of column is for which location. Here, based on the loadings, we will start from the higher size columns, a location where beams from the four directions are resting. We'll have medium size columns for the locations where beams from three directions are resting on the columns, and whereas for the lower size columns, the beams from the two directions will be resting. It has to be noted here that the orientation of columns shall be such that it shall counter the bending moment induced due to the earthquakes. It is up to the designer to decide based on his previous experience. I recommend at least 50% columns oriented in the perpendicular direction. Always note that the column location can only be finalized after marking all the primary and secondary beams in its position for all the floors. Thus, load distribution will be clear and any load flow problem can be detected earlier. Also go through the constraints regarding the type of footings. If there is adjacent plot, then you will have to settle by the provision of an eccentric footing. If columns are closer, then combined footing is the option. Underground structures such as a borehole for water or proposed underground water tank can cause change in the location of columns. All such things shall be in the mind of a designer while designing the building. Beam sizes are based on the wall thicknesses, and the following sizes shall be followed for walls having thickness 9 inches. So the beam size would be 9 by 12 inches, 9 by 15 inches, 9 by 18 inches, and 9 by 21 inches. For walls having thickness 6 inches, the beam sizes would be 6 by 12 inches, 6 by 15 inches, 6 by 18 inches, and 6 by 21 inches, etc. So what we are doing here, we are providing the member sizes such as slab thickness of 125 mm and all the beam and column sizes. Beam sizes are based on the wall thicknesses, and the following sizes shall be followed for walls having thickness 9 inches. So the beam size would be 9 by 12 inches, 9 by 15 inches, 9 by 18 inches, and 9 by 21 inches. For walls having thickness 6 inches, the beam sizes would be 6 by 12 inches, 6 by 15 inches, 6 by 18 inches, and 6 by 21 inches, etc. So what we are doing here, we are providing the member sizes such as slab thickness of 125 mm and all the beam and column sizes. In the AutoCAD drawing, I have marked the column sizes and their orientations. So now as per the plinth height of the building, which is around 1 meter, a line having 1 meter height is drawn along Y axis and copied at all the column center locations. This will serve important after importing the same in the STAD software. We will only save column sizes as marked and the vertical line drawn at the center of each columns. Copy the same at a location, move them at 00 location, and now the file is ready for import. So for importing the CAD file to STAD software, we have to save the same in DXF format. You start STAD software and follow the steps as file import and file DXF import. Remember to place the location at 00 at the origin. Zoom in and remove any unwanted members if they are copied by mistake. Here, we can start giving properties to members as per the sizes allotted earlier for each columns. See to provide orientation of columns as per the CAD footprint. Delete the column size showing footprint lines from the bottom of each columns. Provide the plinth beam sizes as per the span. For higher span, provide larger beam size, and for a smaller span, reduce the beam size. Use translational repeat to copy the same plinth beam frame at 3 meter above. Here, for this case only, you need to again assign column sizes and check their orientation. For the next two floors, again use the translational repeat command, and this time use the entire column.
column and beam grid to copy them for the first and the second floor. Provide fixed supports by copying the column nodes and assign them. Before we apply loads on the structure, let us check for some points to fix any modeling errors. We have already checked the structure for any modeling errors. So now let us apply loads. We need to apply seismic loads first before any other loads, as then only the seismic loads will be considered by the software. The building location is considered in Pune city and parameters related to it are applied. Dead load of 3 kN and live load of 4 kN per square meter is considered. For seismic loading, live load of 2 kN is taken. That is half of the total live load. Load combinations are as per the IS code. We have selected the first few cases only for the analysis. Here static check is important before we do any further analysis to find out the errors in the analysis process.